very difficult to make. I mean, I remember on Star Wars Episode 1, that what became particularly difficult with those films is that they built less of the sets, and it was all about green screen and sure. adding stuff in post-production. Because of course George has at his disposal ILM, who can do amazing things. Sure. And I remember walking onto set one day as Wattle, the Rodian character, and they said to me, would you just go and grab the EOP, the sort of dinosaur-like creature, and I want you to lead it round in a circle and off. And of course I understood there wouldn't be an EOP standing there, but I thought there might be the range, but there was nothing, just a massive area of green. So I have to imagine the whole thing, I have to imagine jumping up, grabbing the reins, pulling on it like there's some resistance, and then pulling this creature and leading him round and off. And not even a rope, there's nothing there. You have to kind of become a kid again and just use your imagination. And that's what filmmaking, and especially working in sci-fi, is all about, is just putting yourself there and trying to visualise what you might see. Because however good ILM are at adding the effects, their work will only be as good as what the actor gives them. If I don't make it look real what I'm seeing, they can't add it in and make it look real, do you know what I mean?
Right, yeah. And so that is a great point. Bit of shield in your nail there for you. Taking your way back. Who am I?
Exactly.
No, and that's really very cool. Okay, so you know, we've been doing this a little with you here, kind of plugging some of the things that you're, because you're very busy now.
Yes,
so
I'm
doing something.
Yeah.
So I think we probably have a shameless plug here, don't we? Yes, let's see. Yes.
Time to click like and follow our guest on a shameless plug.
This is your chance to just shamelessly plug away whatever you got here. So now we have, well, Pocket Warwick.
Oh yeah.
That's
yeah.
an app.
It is an app. There it is.
We love apps. Everybody, I've got apps.
It's
I love these things, right? So you have created your own app.
What is Pocket Warwick? Pocket Warwick is basically that right there. Living inside your electronic handheld device, be it an iPhone or an Android device, an iPad. And it's not just something I put my name to, this is something I kind of just came up with.
Really?
In my little head. Yeah.
Wow. And so why are you in a beard?
Well, the idea is that, you know, he's an actor and you have to send him off to auditions. And in order to go to the audition, you have to dress appropriately.
Oh, sure.
And I think this is his Sherlock Holmes. He was auditioning for short Sherlock Holmes. And I wrote all the movie titles. There's hundreds of different tasks in
there. Oh, yeah, working out. That's good.
Got a stiff voice and some facial expression.
Oh, yeah.
That's when you tip the phone, so you can interact with him by tipping the device. And you've got to make sure he's looked after. And if you leave him alone for too long, he goes into a state that actors do go into when they don't work. He ends up in his dressing gown unshaven.
Which is, yeah.
And a little smell.
Kind of like when we were trying to get you out of your dressing room earlier. You've done well. Well, that is fantastic. Okay, the Pocket Warwick. I'm gonna work on that. I'm going to get my own Pocket Warwick. That's great. Anybody, go get your Pocket Warwick now, right?
It's
great.
It's
a free download. Come on!
Yeah.
Love the Pocket Warwick thing. We love free things. Okay. Well, that has been a wonderful shameless plug. So, now, okay, guys, I thought it'd be fun if we took some questions.
This has been our guest, Shameless Plug.
I love that voiceover.
Was that
you,
guys?
That was me. That was me, yes.
This has been another Shameless Plug.
This is the voice that not even my mother-in-law, she doesn't really get what I do, because at voice actors, people don't get what you do, you know?
Do you ever phone up your relatives and pretend you're someone else?
Yeah, well, I call people as, like, Michael J. Fox and stuff, like, oh, how's it going, you know, okay, anyways, see how it's going, but, okay, so let's do some questions, right? Where's the microphone?
Austin.
Okay, very good. I'm going to take some questions. If you guys are up for it, are you all up for it? British flair to it, was that good?
Yeah, you did that one as well.
Yeah. Right, what do you think? Is that not bad? Yeah, no.
See, that's why they hire you for this gig, Jake, because it's cheap. They can give you random choices.
Okay. I am cheap, that's right. Who has a question for some one of these two gentlemen over here? Anybody a question for Warwick Davis? Got one right back here? Okay. Stand up, come on over here.
Let's see that, yeah, Doctor Who.
Okay, what's your name? Okay, and who do you have a question for?
I forget stuff easily, but it's the dude that played Darth Maul.
Yeah, do that.
You know, I used to hit myself a lot when I used to practice the bow style a lot. And it was one of those things that I hated practicing because the wushu side of it was so, it was so energetic and hard and had to be so precise. And I would walk away from practice with welts on my shins and head. But I did knock myself on the head a few times because I forgot I was wearing horns. And I still have the dents in my head to this day.
Wow.
That's why I'm a little slow.
Okay. No, come on. We have a question. I'm way back here, guys. Hi. How are you? We have a question for Warwick.
Yes.
And
hey, Will.
Will? Warwick. Warwick? Will.
Will. Nice to meet you.
Right.
I have a question, obviously. Could you describe to me how hot that Ewok suit was?
Yeah.
This is probably one of the most common questions I get. I mean, it was very hot.
It was so hot.
It felt like you were wearing sort of your own personal sauna. And the problem was that once you put the head on, the heat from the body would rise up into the head and mist up the eyes. So you really couldn't see. You could tell the difference between light and dark. But that was it. So it was very important you rehearsed where you went, then put the head on, and then kind of did the walk from memory. Because it was tricky. At the end of the take, especially in the Ewok village, they'd call cut, and there would be Ewoks littered everywhere. That had fallen over and then couldn't get up themselves. So I was lucky I was probably one of the last men standing, or kids standing.
Yeah. Well, we have a question here that I felt compelled to take. go ahead with your question there. Yeah.
My question is for Ray Park.
Ah, okay.
Actually, it's not a question. It's more of a statement. I don't think you're so tough. I know. I think it's all a big act. What do you think about that, Mr. Tough Guy?
Yeah, I'm getting sweat sick.
I would forget, and I would have flashy stuff behind me.
Well, this is fun.